An Oscar-nominated actress is raising eyebrows with comments about a move by other celebrities to boycott the Academy Awards. Several stars are shunning the ceremony, if you remember, because there are no black nominees in the acting categories for a second straight year. But Charlotte Rampling says that doing that is anti-white racism. She tells a European radio station, and I'm quoting for you here, "We can never be entirely sure, but perhaps maybe this time no black actor or actress deserve to make it to the final selection." Okay, let's discuss this. Miki Turner joins us live now from Los Angeles. She's a pop culture critic and lecturer at the University of Southern California. So Miki, she says that this is racist towards white people. What's your reaction?
When I first heard this, I didn't know whether to laugh or to cry. But let's say this, because of her age and her nationality, I'm going to assume that inclusion and diversity
is... Why because of her nationality?
Because I think she probably comes from an era in Britain where this wasn't an important issue. You know, you're right. You know, it's not about her nationality mm-hmm. so much, but, you know, we're thinking of this more of as an American mm-hmm. issue. Mm-hmm. So,
but race relations
that
are
said,
different over there?
Yes.
Okay.
Exactly. So that said, I applaud her for having the courage of her convictions. She simply vocalized what a lot of people are thinking, I think, mm-hmm. here, and what a lot of people have written on blogs and websites. But I think her mistake really she's made it a little bit personal.
I see. Do you think there are perhaps other white actors in Hollywood who might feel the same way as Charlotte Rampling, but who perhaps are too afraid to speak up?
Definitely, I think that's the case. And, you know, I think what this whole thing has done, I wrote about this earlier in the week, is that this issue has widened the cultural divide. Mm-hmm. In this country particularly. And all of these people who think that racism and classism are not an issue globally are delusional. It still is. And, you know, this incident that we've been grappling with for the past week has proven that.
I want to read you some comments from Michael Caine, obviously a very famous actor, also British, incidentally. And he said, and I'm quoting for you here, "You can't vote for an actor just because he's black. You can't say, oh, I'm going to vote for him. He's not very good, but he's black. I'll vote for him because he's black." However, he goes on to add, "I saw Idris Elba and I thought that he was wonderful. Did he not get nominated?" What do you make of those comments? Does it seem to you that people perhaps aren't even aware that certain black actors aren't even getting recognized?
Well, I think Idris's issue was that the marketing machine behind him wasn't very good. This is a film that, you know, had a brief theatrical run and then, you know, was aired on Netflix. But I think the issue is that even when Jada came out and said what she said, even when Spike came out and said what he said, no one ever said that none of these 20 Caucasian nominees deserve not to be there.
Right.
Charlotte Rampling made it personal.
Some people are saying that, you know, people like Spike Lee and Will Smith are very wealthy. They can afford to speak up. They can afford to say, you know what, I'm not going to go to the Oscars. I'm going to boycott the Oscars. Whereas the younger, mm-hmm. upcoming black actors, they don't really have the voice to do that because there's so much riding on them making an appearance at the Oscars and sort of following protocol.
Well, you know, these are people who weren't going to be invited anyway. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I understand their dilemma, but, you know, as someone who grew up in the 60s, when Jim Crow was still sort of in a shallow grave, you know, if not now, then when? You know, you've got to stand up for what is right. And, you know, this diversity issue at the Academy is less about racism than it is about numbers, really. Mm-hmm. Cheryl Boone Isaacs is trying to increase the numbers so that the voting Academy, you know, the playing field there is a little bit more even.
What do you think of those changes she's proposing?
I think she has many challenges ahead of her mm-hmm. Because she's going up against a well-oiled machine. But I applaud her for making the effort, and I hope that the entire creative community gets behind her, and that's people of all hues, and that's what it's going to take.
One other thing that
because
Michael...
Because a couple of people not coming to the show, I mean, the show will go on.
Right, right. One other thing that Michael Caine did say in a recent interview is that black actors should be patient, that their time will come. What do you make of that?
Their time will come when? You know, movies have been around since, you know, the 1800s. I mean, how that, yeah, I can't get with that statement at all. I do think that, you know, there's just a different perspective, you know, between the black and white communities on this issue. And, you know, I understand what they, how they feel in a way, mm-hmm. but we're tired.
Right.
We're tired of waiting, you know, and no, there's not going to be any more waiting, I don't think. I think right now it's at a point where nobody wants to wait anymore.
And you've got Chris Rock, obviously a very famous black comedian, hosting. Is this an opportunity for him to perhaps use it to make light, use the fact that, you know, no black actors are in the audience, to make light of it, to sort of use for materials for jokes?
That's the $64,000 question, because, you know, as you know, some people are calling for him not to even show up. You know, he's been in that role before, and he's made those comments before. This year, I don't know that it's going to have any more impact because of everything that's been going on, you know, prior to the show. And I honestly don't know what he should do. He has to sort of tap into his own consciousness and
see which way he should go. Right. It's taken a more serious tone this year, but unfortunately, that's all we have time for.
Right.
Miki Turner, I appreciate the discussion. Thank you so much. We appreciate that.